Every gene in our genome contributes to the life of an organism by encoding proteins. However, surprisingly, humans only have 20,000 genes, while we have an estimate of 150,000 proteins. This is because every single gene can produce many different proteins. How does it do it? Through a process called alternative splicing. First, a gene will be transcribed into a molecule called a pre-messenger RNA that will then be chopped or spliced into different versions that will then encode for proteins. So on average, each of our genes can produce 7 different proteins that will then have different functions. Therefore, RNA splicing is a major regulatory event in cells that is controlled by protein called splicing factors. And defect in splicing leads to a large number of diseases. We now have evidence that a large number of genetic diseases, including cancer, display aberrant splicing, leading to the generation of the wrong protein at the wrong time in the cell. Pharmaceutical companies have recently shown a strong interest in redirecting aberrant splicing for genetic diseases. This is very encouraging and shows that we can treat genetic diseases through splicing modulation. However, so far, all the strategies have been done on mutation of one single gene, leading to changes in one single pre-mRNA. Far more reaching strategies to target alternative splicing of more complex diseases, such as cancer, need to be developed. One way would be to target splicing factors that are either overexpressed or mutated. My lab work on a splicing factor called SAM68. SAM68 regulates splicing through its RNA binding ability, and its overexpression has been observed in many different tumors. There is now accumulating evidence showing that SAM68 has oncogenic properties and contributes to the progression of tumors. SAM68 is also regulated by extracellular signal and cell signaling that are often deregulated in cancer. And deregulated signaling leads to aberrant activity of SAM68. In our lab, we have recently revealed the structural basis of RNA recognition by SAM68 and identified pockets that could be targeted by small molecules. We have also developed a high-throughput screening assay with the hope to find inhibitors of SAM68. Here in Leicester, we have the capability to perform structure-based drug optimization and validation of compounds in cell-based models such as lymphoma. We are now looking for a pharmaceutical company willing to collaborate with us and screen their library using our high-throughput screening assay.